This is how I find my laser settings. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about sharing my workflow to find my perfect laser settings. Be it whatever material, this is usually the steps that I take for every single material that comes in. For this video, I got a hold of some jute burlap wrap, which I wanted to basically just see how nicely I could go ahead and get an engraving on it or a kiss cutting score line on it, and also seeing how quickly I could cut it as well. I've never worked with this material before, so let's go into the workflow of how I found the laser settings for this. Firstly, it comes to safety. I make sure that the material is safe to laser cut, and that's purely done by research online. And if at any point I hear anything of any chemical, especially chlorine, or if it's really high in formaldehyde, I usually go ahead and step back from that material. But if you're aware that there's nothing bad with it, then I go on to the next step. To start off with, I preferably like to start with engraving first, as it's usually the lowest power you're going to be using while working with a certain material, and you get to find out where the burning points of a material is. So for something like this burlap, it's going to be quite low. So first of all, I go ahead and I create this file here. So what I like to do here is give myself a nice big block here to get my laser up to full speed. And then I've got all these other smaller ones over on this side here that this is to represent text. So I get an idea, and what I do is go 0.5, 1 millimeter, 1.5 millimeter, all the way up to 3 millimeters here at the end to see the type of engravings that I get at all the different power settings. Now, for the initial engraving, you have to really do a bit of a stab in the dark, but my rule of thumb is to start low and then go up. So using a bit of power deduction, a bit of online research if you don't know what settings to go with here, I felt comfortable starting with a speed of 1000 on my Glowforge and then going for a power setting of about 5%, considering that when I'm doing wood, I'm at about 50% for quite a deep engraving. And when I'm kiss cutting, I'm only at 10 power, but I'm at 1/5 of the speed. So I thought that would be a good starting point. So this here was my first result. From there, I decided that I also wanted to do two other results. And the way that I do this is I step it up only using one setting higher. So I already had my DPI set, because I knew that I wanted to get relatively good resolution. So I had 256 DPI, and then I put up my power up by 5. And I did two other tests, so I had one at 10 power and one at 15 power, and what I found is then later on, when I actually touched my final other two tests down here, they just fell apart. So obviously this burlap wrap is going to be quite heat susceptible, and made sure that then if I'm going to be doing any engraving, it's going to be up here, but I've got to make sure that it's thick enough, because I can see over here that even on my 1 millimeter, I can hardly see how that's coming out. So I decided that from this point that I needed to explore my score lines, because that's my next power rating up, because I'm going to be going at a slower speed, thus the same amount of power that I might be using up here is going to be a lot more intense. So, having done the research of the above, I know that if I go at about 15 power, I'm getting close to a cut. So I don't want to go too much higher above that. So then down here, I create a new file, which again, I have a nice long line so that my laser can get up to speed and we get a true representation. This is very important for those lasers that aren't like Glowforge that are automatically calibrated. If you don't have a Glowforge, what you have to do is you've got the correction value, which is the power ramping to your speed ramp that you're going to have to play around with. And what you'll have there is it'll either overcut or undercut the score at each end. And what you basically have to play around is finding the perfect tuning so that you get a clean line. And that's why we have this part over here of all these other little lines. So what we have is a 1 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 3 millimeter, 4 millimeter, all the way up to a 5 or 6 millimeter over there. So we just get an idea of, with the ramping, do we have the correct settings? It sometimes comes that when you're working with very susceptible materials and you're wanting a very precise line, you're going to have to even create two settings, one for longer lines and one for shorter lines, depending on the size of the project that you're working with. So after coming out with these results here, I was starting to get really happy, and I decided what I was going to do is for my other tests down here, that I would actually go ahead and play around with defocusing, because I realized that up here, I straight away hit the nail on the head because of my tests above, and I knew where the heat limit was for my jute fibers here. So what I went ahead and did is realizing that I'm going to have a really hard time with the fibers, that I went and unfocused my laser to create thicker lines. I did an entire video on unfocusing. You can go check that out. It's in the card or down in the description. So then what I did is I did an unfocusing of only 3 millimeters. So I have a hairline, which is my normal kiss cut line. Then I've got my 3 millimeter off line, which is basically a thinnish line. And then I wanted a really thick line. So here, down here, I just went the highest possible that my Glowforge does, which if I set that to 10, it's going up to around about 10 millimeter offset from the base, because it can take a good 6 millimeters of material, and this is hardly even a millimeter. Anyway, lastly from there, using that exact same file, we go ahead and we go into the cuts. Now the cuts was very much, you have your information from the above. So using our kiss cut, so we know that point where we don't want to go over, but you're also using the information from our engraving, so the type of power that it becomes brittle, or it becomes too deep of an engraving if you're working with wood, we go to the cut lines. Now the cut lines, through the power of deduction, I basically did it the same as my kiss cut or scoring lines, which I like to be at about 200 speed, because that means if I get a really complicated design, the power seems to stay rather consistent for me. If you have your speed too high, you might have quite inconsistent power depending on the laser that you're using. So when it came to the cut, I knew that I needed to go above 15, because 15 power gave me this burnout here. So I go and set that top one to 20. Now, knowing the way that laser cutting works, and especially when it comes to materials, we have these smaller lines that worked out pretty well. But I realize when you're working with natural materials, there are going to be inconsistencies. So what I would say, especially with cut settings, go about 10% up. Or if you don't mind marking the back of your material, go a little bit higher still, because you never know. I might have a really thick jute fiber somewhere in here that I wouldn't want to ruin a piece with. So having done that, I then did one more test down here, going all the way up to 30. And the main thing that I saw here was on the back, I had some marking that I wasn't really happy with, but at the same time, I knew that I was cutting through the material very cleanly. Having found my settings, you now need to go and put them to the test. What I like to do is something a bit like this badge here. So what I have is an engraving test, then I have my thin line test, my thick line test, and my cut line test. This is all the settings that I would need for a future project. So let's show you the file that I use, which is this one here, really easy to set up. And then from there, we go ahead and cut it out. Taking that out of the laser, we now know that we have the perfect laser settings that we're happy with, that we can see the engraving, see our hairline, see our thick line, and see our cut line. And from there, we know that we can go ahead and do a project. So for me, one of the main projects that I wanted to do was engraving on this burlap. So I straight away went ahead and did an engraving, and that there is the lovely result from it. Now, there is one thing. This took an age to do. In fact, it took me an hour to do this one engraving. Of course, I'm using a Glowforge, which isn't exactly the fastest for engraving. So I realized that I had to put in a bit of time to create some line art from the same artwork. And this here is that line art right there. So after about 4 hours of doing some line art, that there is the outcome. And this only took 12 minutes to make. So you can see that side by side, we've got 1 hour and 12 minutes. So of course, that not being big enough for me, I went and did it the entire size of the Glowforge, which comes out with this beautiful piece right here. And for those of you wondering where I got this artwork from, well, this is from the Biodiversity Heritage Library. They've gone ahead and uploaded 150,000 field sketch illustrations on their Flickr page to open public domain. They're doing this to encourage people to understand what a field sketch is, as well as just bringing out the news that there's all this incredible artwork out there and they just want to bring it out to the public. Because it's in public domain, you can go ahead over there, get as much inspiration from them, even create line artwork from the sketches themselves. So the link is down in the description to that Flickr page. Some last closing tips when it comes to laser settings. This is how I've found laser settings best work for myself. This is after a lot of testing with all types of testing ways to find settings. Now, you might find that you like to find your cut settings first and then your engraving. I feel that going from a lower power to a higher power is not only safer, but usually gives me more information when I'm going into finding settings for new materials. When it comes to materials, keep in mind that when you're working with things that are very inconsistent, for instance, leather, maybe a 10% isn't enough to go above when you're doing a cut, but you might even have to go 50 or 30% higher up due to the variation in thickness. This is the same for wood as well, especially if you're doing plywood, because there can be occlusions within the plywood or even knots, which can really ruin your day if you're getting stopped by a knot every now and then. So make sure that you give yourself enough power to cut through these pesky knots, but at the same time that you don't get too much flash back from the bottom to give you a lot of secondary work when you're sanding and cleaning off your projects. And on a quick side note, if you're interested in getting this line art right here, the link is down in the description where you can go ahead and get it for the price of a premium coffee, because it took me definitely more than a couple of coffees to make that. Anyway, guys, a huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome. It means the world to me. If you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord channel. The link is down in the description as well, and join the maker conversation there. Thank you for watching. Keep making and let the quest continue.